Hey my glam girls, welcome back to my channel. It's Chelsea, and today, so I get it, I did it guys. I picked up the Pat McGrath, the Mothership Mega Celestial Divinity Palette. I'd asked you guys in a couple of videos back, are you guys interested in it? And I even told you all that I wasn't like, you know, oh my God, another Pat palette. But I read through the comments and I was like, you know what? I think there's enough interest to do the video. So we're gonna be doing two eye looks in this video. I'll of course be sharing with you my thoughts and my opinions on the palette. I'll incorporate some swatches at the end of the video and then we'll be done. But before we get into this video, I just wanna say thank you so much for taking time out of your day to spend some time with me. If this is your first time here, I'd love for you to stick around and subscribe to my channel and join the Glam Girl Squad. And if you are a returning subscriber, well, thank you so much for deciding to come back and support my channel with all of y'all's likes and comments. They all truly do mean a lot to me. So let's get into this video. So, outfit of the day is a little special number. This is the dress that I wore in my gender reveal. If you all saw pictures of it on my Instagram page or here on the community tab, you've seen this dress before. This dress is also from Shein. Do not sleep on Shein. They actually have some really good deals. You just have to read the comments so that you can get an idea of like what the quality is and things like that. But the bottom of the dress, sorry, I can't show you all full length, but the bottom of the dress is blue. And once again, you can go take a look at my Instagram, Glam Girl Chelsea, to see it full on out. But it's so cute. I felt like it was a really good, like, cute piece for a gender reveal because it's got pink. This is cream. This is so cute. And then it's definitely like bump friendly. She's growing, guys. And then my necklace, it's a cross necklace, really cute and dainty, also by The Style Collection. I love their jewelry. So love it. Like I told y'all before, I love cute and dainty jewelry. Okay, of course, I will link everything down in the description box below. Now let's get into the palette. So if you have not seen the newest palette by Mother, here we go. So this is, like I said, the Mothership Mega Celestial Divinity Palette. This is going to be featuring 18 shades. And I would dare to say this is Mother's first big, large palette. It does retail for $78 and you can get it from the Pat McGrath website, or you can also purchase it now from Sephora. So in this particular palette, 12 of the 18 shades are repeat shades. So the shades in this row and the shades in this row are from two previous six pan launches that she did last holiday season. Those palettes are not currently available. So if you wanted those palettes and you did not have them, this middle row right here is actually a row of new shades. So for me, I actually don't have those other two palettes. So I am not seeing, or I'm not repeating shades in my collection. But if you do have those other two palettes and you are familiar with it, then in this particular palette, you're only getting six new shades. There are no special shades in this particular palette, but we are getting three mattes and then we're getting 15 shimmers in the palette. Packaging is really, it's actually better than I thought. When I saw pictures of the packaging, I was not impressed. I was just like, I'm not gonna lie, I still would have enjoyed this being the black luxurious packaging. I would have paid for that. I know that's kind of crazy, but I would have paid more for it. But this actually is not bad. So it is, it's, you know, that cardboard type of packaging, but the palette is actually thin. So I was happy about that because I thought this was going to be like that thick cardboard packaging, and I think that turned me off. But I do like that it's thin, so it is easier to store in terms of its compactness. And then when you open it, you do have these two material pieces, I don't know what I would call them, here that help to kind of keep the mirror propped up. So if I were doing my makeup, depending on how my tabletop was situated, you actually can have the mirror sitting up while you're doing your makeup. And then of course, don't wanna blind you, but there's a really nice sized mirror in this particular palette. So I think we've got all of that out of the way. Let's come in a little closer and do these eyelids. Priming with the ABH primer. And I'm only priming one eye because on this eye, I wanna use one of her eye kohls to prime that eye, set the base. So, BK Beauty 202 brush. And I wanna go in with this matte shade and let us make this a transition shade. Let's go going with this shade right here. Picking a Refer 02 brush. This looks pretty. And let's concentrate this one right here. This one is a shimmer shade, but it has more of like a matte like finish. I mean, you see the shimmer particles in it, but it looks more matte than shimmer, if that makes sense. So this is a good shade to use like a matte shade if you wanted to put it like in the outer corner of the eye like I'm doing. Taking the same brush, and we're gonna go in with this shade right here. Ooh. Now this, my friends, is gorgeous. Especially blending it into that black shade. Oh, that's so pretty. Do y'all see that? I didn't even intentionally do that. I had the remainder of what was on the black shade, like, went on ahead and outlined that inner corner. How cute is that? Let's go in with this shade right here. Same brush, Refer 02, center right here, just to like add a little pop to the center of the eye. This shade, I definitely think I need to spray my brush. It's definitely more of a metallic shade. So I sprayed my brush with my Lila B A Glow Face Mist. And yeah, now we're seeing her come alive. Let's take this shade right here and a Refer 03 brush. Start lining that lower lash line a little bit. And then let's take this shade right here. And we're gonna put that in the middle of the lower lash line. Oh, that's so pretty. Wiping off the Refer 03 brush, and then we're gonna go in with this shade right here. Ooh, perfect. I didn't even know it was gonna look like this, but perfect. I'm actually gonna go in with one of the Wayne Goss eye kohls. I have the Pat McGrath eye kohl, but if I'm being really honest, the Wayne Goss ones are so much better because they are much more blendable than the Pat McGrath ones. So I'm gonna take the eye kohl in Rich Hazel. This is a matte brown eye kohl, and carve out just this outer area of the eye. Very messy, and that's okay because we're gonna blend that out. So taking a Refer 15 brush, and we are going to just blend this out all across this outer area of the eye. And I want to go in with this matte shade right here. So we're going to pack this on this outer area of the eye. And I'm using a Sogeji Builder Pro brush with this shade right here. And add this right in this area of the eye. And then we're gonna go in with this shade right here. Same brush, just wiped it off. And we're gonna put that right here. Oh, that's so pretty. I think I wanna mix this. Like mix this in with that kind of burgundy-ish gold shade. Very, very pretty. Night look, day look. Now going in with a Refer 13 brush. Just going with the last matte shade right here. With this shade right here. Then in a corner, this one right here. Oh, that's pretty. That's a pretty one. All right, guys, so these are my two eye looks. I'm gonna finish off my face, throw on some lashes, and then I will come back and share with you my final thoughts. Okay guys, so this is the finished eye looks, or these are the finished eye looks, and I think they both turned out pretty nicely. I did throw on some lashes, so I am wearing the Ardell Naked Lashes in style 421. I have on the Pat McGrath Foundation, the Armani Luminous Silk Concealer, threw on some Charlotte Tilbury bronzer in the shade tan, and I used the Wayne Goss blush palette in the shade Bright Poppy. And then on my lips, I have on Pat McGrath lipstick in Labasia with the NYX Suede lip liner. So final thoughts on this palette. I must say, I liked it better on the eyes than I thought I would. I told you all before, I was just like, I don't even know if I wanna get it. It's not really calling to me like her other palettes do. And after using it, I think this palette is pretty nice. I do like the shimmer shades. I think, of course, the palette is full of shimmer shades and some metallic shades. I like the formula of the shimmer shades. They were really nice and smooth, full pigment. It glided on really nicely. So this really bright, beautiful purple shade, that was an example of the shimmer shades I'm talking about. And then these two shimmers that I used on my eyes, that gold and then that like that burgundy gold, all three of those were those shimmer shades that I really enjoyed, and I felt that the color payoff was just one swipe, full color payoff. The metallic shades, which the metallic shades would be this one shade that I use in the center of the eye right here that I had to use my setting spray to help it, you know, adhere to the eye and pop. That one, it was okay. It wasn't as impressive as some of the other shades were. But then this metallic shade, which I use on the inner corner of my eye, that one like popped in and of its own. I didn't have to add like anything to it to make it pop. So all around, I didn't use every shade in the palette, but I did use a decent amount of shades in the palette. I think this is a pretty decent palette. I don't think this is a need at all. If you have Pat McGrath palettes that you love, especially if you have the other 12 shades, you know, in theory, if you were to get this palette, you're paying $78 for 6 shades. Not saying that we haven't done that in this luxury world of ours, but to kind of put things into perspective, if you have the other two palettes featuring the 12 shades that are in this particular one, and you aren't overly like, I have to have the shades in the middle, if you're not like a completionist, then I definitely think you could pass on this. And even if you don't have those other 12 shades already, if this doesn't speak to you and if you don't feel like you have to have it, I don't think it's a need. It's definitely not one of Pat's best formulated eyeshadow palettes. But I do think it's nice, and I would definitely recommend it to people who were eyeing it, who felt like, I think I would like it. I don't have things like this in my collection, and I think I would get some good use out of it, then I would recommend it. Overall, I had a really good time playing with this palette, and like I said, I wasn't disappointed by any of the shades. You know, like that one shade that I had to spray, I mean, I had to spray it, but it wasn't like, you know, they were patchy on the eyelids. The mattes that I used, all three of the mattes blended really nice. So yeah, I think this is a nice palette. I would say nice, solid palette. A need, no, but a nice solid palette to give you nice beautiful looks. And that's it, guys. I did take a look at my other Pat palettes to see if I felt like there was comparisons of shades, and I really didn't feel like there was. The only other palette that I thought of just from looking at this one that I felt like there might be some similarity of shades was this one right here. This is the Rose Decadence palette. There were, you know, a couple of shades in the Mega Mothership that I felt were a little similar to the Rose Decadence. I'm trying to get these up here side by side, but I can't do it. but I feel like the color stories are different enough to where they're not going to be obviously similar on the eye. And it was really just these two shades, these two matte shades from the Rose Decadence that I felt like could have been sort of similar to this shade, and this palette, but I know that they're not similar. I know that they're not repeat shades, especially when I say repeat shades, repetitive of what's in here. So outside of this palette, there wasn't any other palettes that I felt like, oh, these are worth swatching and comparing to. I will go ahead and link Kinky Sweat's channel down below. I know she's done like, I wanna say 3 or 4 videos on this particular palette already, and you know she's the queen of swatches and comparisons. So if you wanna see some comparisons to other palettes that I probably don't have that I know that she has, definitely check out her channel, and Alicia got you covered on all of that stuff. But guys, this is it. Let me know your thoughts down below on what you think of the eye looks. what you think of the palette. Some of you all already shared kind of what you were thinking of the last time I posed a question of if you were interested in the palette. So leave your thoughts down below. Now that we've got to see it a little bit in action, tell me if you still feel the same way. And that's it, guys. Thank you so much for watching, and I really hope to see you in my very next video. Bye, guys.